Okay, we did pronunciation, I think, of almost all of the countries in the world in English. So I'll go through the 50 US states here. This is a map. So, first of all, there's Alaska, which is off in the north west corner. Alaska is actually out here, where I'm pointing, and the rest of the US is out here. And then there's also Hawaii, which is a collection of islands in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. Okay, but the rest of the US are the 48 contiguous states. This is sometimes called the contiguous states, meaning they're attached to each other. So I'll read them off. Washington. There's also a city called Washington, which is the capital of the US, right? And it's down in between Maryland and Virginia. But this is called Washington State, and it's different than Washington, D.C., which is the capital city. Okay, Washington, Oregon. California, which is the state with the most people. Alaska, Hawaii, right, which is, like I said, Alaska is actually up north and Hawaii is in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, but they're just stuck here in the corner in this map, right? So, Nevada, Idaho, Montana, Wyoming, Utah, Colorado, Arizona, New Mexico, not to be confused with the country Mexico, which is south of the US. Then there is Texas, Oklahoma, Kansas, Nebraska, South Dakota, North Dakota, Minnesota, Iowa, Missouri, Arkansas. The S at the end there is not pronounced. It's Arkansas, Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, Florida, South Carolina, North Carolina, Tennessee, Kentucky, Virginia, Illinois, Indiana, Ohio, which is one of the states with a very high population. Michigan is also a state with a high population, and that's where Detroit, the city of Detroit, is, where the auto industry is. Then we have Wisconsin, Minnesota, and there's New York. There is New York State, and the city of New York is on Manhattan Island. The city of New York is part of New York State. Pennsylvania, West Virginia, there. Washington, D.C., which is the capital of the U.S., and it's not a state, and it's not part of a state, but it's a special area. D.C. there means District of Columbia. D.C. there means Then there's Maryland, Delaware, New Jersey, which is beside New York. Connecticut. It's normally pronounced with that C being silent. I think a few people might say Connecticut, but most people say Connecticut, and the middle C is silent. And then there's Rhode Island, the smallest state. And there's Massachusetts down here, Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine. Right. Just just as a bonus here, I'll explain about the time zones. Most people in North America live in the Eastern time zone here in the East Coast. There's also the Central time zone. Not very many people live in the Central time zone. There's the Mountain time zone. That's where the Rocky Mountains are. And there's the Pacific time zone, which is the west coast of North America. There's also the Atlantic time zone, where there are not that many people live in the Atlantic time zone here. And then there's the province of Newfoundland in Canada, which has its own time zone here, this area here. But most people in North America live in the Eastern time zone, and then except for people who live in California, who live in the Pacific time zone. So there's 3 hours difference. One, this is, say, if you start here, then there's 1, 2, 3 hours difference between the East Coast and the West Coast, the Eastern time zone and the Pacific time zone, which is on the West Coast. So that was the English language lesson for today. Thank you.